Thank you so much, Ambassador Joseph Asako, for being with us here on Rwanda Television. Now, the first one, Africa owns 60% of the global arable land, but we still suffer. We still import food from the rest of the world. Are you concerned that this is something that is not right, and are you working towards eliminating that?
This is something that we are concerned because we import about 35 billion yearly. So we are really bringing programs to really revamp our agriculture, transform the agriculture on the continent, because 35 billion that we import every year, we are giving the market elsewhere, as you say, when we have 60% of arable land. So I think we shall have to change the narrative of how doing business. Agriculture is very profitable, so we need to really start working seriously and eliminate the issue of import bill, because it's a shame for us, because we are buying things, giving markets to other regions when we can, we have the potential to do it. So this narrative, if it changes, and it's going to change, we are working with our member countries, we are working with our RECs, so that we can change this pattern. And I believe that today's, since yesterday's dialogue, is part of it, because we have a very high representation. We're able to, have a participation of 42 ministers on the continent. They are the ones that make decision on the countries. So it's commitment, they are committed. So I think the narrative is going to change on, importing $35 billion of foods to feed our population.
Sure. There's also been a push for genetically modified fertilizers to improve agriculture yields. Do you think that's the safest way to go for Africa?
As an institution, I think countries are sovereign, and they should base on the science advice or evidence, if it is good or it is not good. If countries think that it is good and is going to increase productivity, let them go ahead, because there's a lot of controversy about this debate. Yeah. And we haven't tabled it at the African Union Commission.
You haven't?
We haven't tabled it. Yeah. But with my colleague, the Commissioner for Science and Science and Technology and Innovation, I think with what I have here, it's about time, if at all we want to improve our productivity. And our partners, mostly the scientists, communities are telling us that this is the way forward for the seeds, GMOs. It's a debate, and I think we need to open the debate at the African Union in order to guide our member states with evidence. We have a lot of scientists community in Africa. We have FARA, we have the WIITA, we have ASAREKA. All these institutions should come together, and the farmers' organization to tell us their experience. And then after, maybe we can embark on what the scientific community is telling us.
Sure. And last one, but not the least, of course, there's this agreement that has been signed between FAO and World Food Programme and other African institutions. What should we expect different from this agreement that you've signed?
I think the communique we sign is, it engages us, it engages all the partners, African Union, the World Bank, African Development Bank, FAO, and IFAD. So I believe when you make a big project, a bankable project, and the bank is next to you, you are sure that things will move. Because most of the time when we do our own forum, mostly this sector that is very marginalized in terms of access to finance, so when you do, usually the finance people don't want to join us because they say that the farmers are not credible. So they don't give us grants, loans. And with this, big institutions, World Bank is a global institution and makes policy and, makes policy, strategy and development. I think we are on the right way. We are really on the right way. We had the opportunity to have, this is an initiative of the World Bank that approached the African Union Commission as the umbrella for our policies, you know, agriculture policies, climate change policies, environmental policies on the continent. And we embarked with FAO that has the expertise, IFAD that has the expertise. So all the important stakeholders signed that document, and we need to be credible. Okay. When you sign a document, we cannot play with our population, and we cannot be proud to say Africa is the most food insecure on the planet, with about 256 billion people undernourished. It's a shame for us. As leaders, we need to change the narrative.
Do you think the continental free trade area has anything to play in regarding ending hunger in Africa?
It has something to play because you need to market foods and save food, of course. So it has something to play because where you have gaps or lack of some commodity, you can exchange. If, for instance, West Africa has a lot of rice and East Africa has a lot of maize, so we can exchange. So it's a good opportunity. And most of the trade have been done by agricultural produce in Africa. I can say up to 75% of the trade, the intra-African trade, are made with this sector. So this sector has to be ready, you know, to create agropark, to industrialize the continent. We are working already with the ADB. ADB has an initiative. We have our initiative, the AgroPAC, and the ADB is looking at agro processing, a very strong agro processing. So we met about 2 weeks ago with the president, Dr. Adesina, and we are going to continue this conversation. And under this framework that we just signed, you know, the communique, so we are going to advance mostly with the ADB. We are going to look more on the CFTA.
Good luck, Ambassador.
Thank you. Thank you.